Hello children, with the help of activity we can verify many results. In geometry we do come across lines which are parallel, perpendicular and intersective. Today we shall perform an activity shows that the triangles on the same base and between the same parallel lines are equal in area. To perform this activity the material required are squared papers, sketch pens and ruler. Now to perform this activity we take squared paper. Children, you can see here horizontal lines and vertical lines. All horizontal lines are parallel to each other and all vertical lines are parallel to each other, and horizontal line is perpendicular to vertical line. Here you can see many squares. We consider each square as one square unit. Now we draw two parallel lines on this squared paper. Now I draw a line L. We name it as L, and I draw another parallel line. And we name it as M. Now we have two lines, line L and line M. These two lines are parallel to each other. L is parallel to M. Now we draw one triangle. I want to take two points on line L. So now here I will take a point here and point here. Now I name it as A and B. And for the third point, I take a point on line M. We take this as C. Now we draw We take this as C. Now we have triangle ABC in between two parallel lines L and M. Now we take another point on M, T. Now we join AD and DB. Children, you can observe that we have two triangles ABC and ABD on the same base and between two parallel lines. Now we have to verify whether the areas of these two are equal or not. For that, we take the replica of this diagram. So here the line L and line M. And we have the triangle ABC and we have the triangle ABD. Now we find the area of this triangle by counting the squares. While counting the squares, we follow the procedure. The squares which are fully covered, we take it as one square unit and we indicate by F. The square which are covered more than half, we also considered it as one square unit and we indicate by M. The squares which are half covered are indicated by half square unit and indicated by H. And the squares which are less than half are ignored. Now we count the squares on triangle ABC. Here you can see that first we will find out the squares which are fully covered, we indicate by F. So this is F, fully covered, this is fully covered, this is fully covered, this is fully covered, and this is fully covered, and this also fully covered, this also fully covered, this also fully covered, but this line is belongs to other triangle. So we consider this ABC only, and this is also fully covered, this is fully covered, and this is fully covered, this is fully covered F, and this is also fully covered, and this is fully covered, and this is also fully covered. Now we count the square which are covered more than half. If you see here, it is covered more than half, so we indicate by M, and this also covered more than half, and this also covered more than half. Now if you see here, here these 6 are exactly covered half, so we indicate by H. So we marked the squares on the triangle ABC. Similarly, we mark the squares on the triangle ABD. Here you can see that this is fully covered, and this is fully covered, this is fully covered, this is fully covered. Here you can see that pink line, but we have to concentrate only on ABD triangle, and this F is, and this also fully covered, and F. Now we see the squares which are covered more than half. From here it is covered more than half, this also covered more than half, this and this one. So the remaining are less than half, that is why we ignore them. Now we find the area of this triangle ABC and triangle ABD. In the triangle ABC, the fully covered squares are 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15. So write 15 here. And more than halves, if you count here, 1, 2, 3, then write 3 here. And exactly half, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Now we find the area of this triangle ABC. So triangle ABC area, it is fully covered plus more than half covered plus half of half covered, because H we are taking it as half square unit. Then it will be 15 plus 3 plus half into 6, that is 15 plus 3 plus 3. It is 21 square units. Now we got the area of the triangle ABC is 21 square units. Now we find the area of the triangle ABD. So here we count the fully covered squares as 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13. Now more than half covered squares will be 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. In this diagram, there are no squares which are exactly covered half. Less than half covers are ignored. Now we find the area of the triangle ABD as F plus M plus half of H. So here fully covered is 13 plus more than half covered 8 plus half into half covered is 0. Then it is 13 plus 8 is equal to 21 square units. Children, we have observed that the area of the triangle ABC and the area of the triangle ABD are equal. So here we verified that the triangle on the same base and between the same parallel lines are equal in area. Now we verify this result by formula method. Here these two triangles are in between two parallel lines, means the height of these two triangles are equal. Now we check here. AM, this is the height. DN, this is the height. Here you can see that the base AB is 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7 units and the height is 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 units. And it is same for the triangle ABC and also for the triangle ABD. So, here in the triangle ABC, the base is 7 units and the height is 6 units. So, the area of the triangle ABC is equal to half into 7 into 6. It is half base into height. 2 goes 3 times. It is 21 square units. And even in the triangle ABD, the base is 7 units and height 6 unit. And the area of the triangle ABD is equal to half into 7 into 6. 2 goes 3 times. It is 21 square units. Children, we have verified that the triangles on the same base and between the same parallel lines are equal in area. You can verify by taking different measurement of base and between different parallel lines and you can explore. You have a question for you. Here, these two lines are parallel, means L is parallel to M. Here, these two triangles are not on the same base, but the measure of the base is equal and they are in between the same parallel lines. You check whether the areas of these two triangles are equal or not. And another question for you. You see this chart. Here there are three parallel lines, L, M, N, they are parallel to each other. Here we have two triangles ABC and ABD. The base of these two triangles are equal and they are in between two different parallel lines where they are parallel to each other. By using this method, you verify whether the areas of these two triangles are equal or not. Hope you have understood. Thank you.